transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonically transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonic Wave, transforming text into the audio realm. Our programs are produced entirely in the USA and read by professional narrators who are compensated for their services at prevailing union rates. We hope you enjoy this program.
The Story of Big Klaus and Little Klaus, compiled by Andrew Lang, narrated by Michelle Ford. In a certain village, there lived two people who had both the same name. Both were called Klaus, but one owned four horses and the other only one. In order to distinguish the one from the other, the one who had four horses was called Big Klaus, and the one who had only one horse, Little Klaus. Now you shall hear what befell them both, for this is a true story. The whole week through, Little Klaus had to plough for Big Klaus and lent him his one horse. Then Big Klaus lent him his four horses, but only once a week, and that was on Sunday. Hurrah! How loudly Little Klaus cracked his whip over all the five horses, for they were indeed as good as his on this one day. The sun shone brightly, and all the bells in the church towers were pealing. The people were dressed in their best clothes and were going to church, with their hymn books under their arms, to hear the minister preach. They saw Little Klaus ploughing with the five horses, but he was so happy that he kept on cracking his whip and calling out, "Gee up, my five horses!"
"You mustn't say that," said Big Klaus. "Only one horse is yours."
But as soon as someone else was going by, Little Klaus forgot that he must not say it and called out, "Gee up, my five horses!"
"Now you had better stop that," said Big Klaus, "for if you say it once more, I will give your horse such a crack on the head that it will drop down dead on the spot."
"I really won't say it again," said Little Klaus. But as soon as more people passed by and nodded him good morning, he became so happy in thinking how well it looked to have five horses ploughing his field, that cracking his whip, he called out,
"Gee up, my five horses!"
"I'll see to your horses," said Big Klaus.
And seizing an iron bar, he struck Little Klaus' one horse such a blow on the head that it fell down and died on the spot.
"Alas! Now I have no horse," said Little Klaus, beginning to cry.
Then he flayed the skin off his horse, dried it, and put it in a sack, which he threw over his shoulder and went into the town to sell it. He had a long way to go, and had to pass through a great dark forest. A dreadful storm came in which he lost his way, and before he could get on the right road, night came on, and it was impossible to reach the town that evening. Right in front of him was a large farmhouse. The window shutters were closed, but the light came through the chinks. "I should very much like to be allowed to spend the night there," thought Little Klaus, and he went and knocked at the door. The farmer's wife opened it, but when she heard what he wanted, she told him to go away. Her husband was not at home, and she took in no strangers. "Well, I must lie down outside," said Little Klaus, and the farmer's wife shut the door in his face. Close by stood a large haystack, and between it and the house a little outhouse, covered with a flat thatched roof. "I can lie down there," thought Little Klaus, looking at the roof. "It will make a splendid bed, if only the stork won't fly down and bite my legs." For a live stork was standing on the roof where it had its nest. So Little Klaus crept up to the outhouse, where he lay down and made himself comfortable for the night. The wooden shutters over the windows were not shut at the top, and he could just see into the room. There stood a large table, spread with wine.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.